four supplements proven to help with skin tightening. Today I'm discussing skin tightening supplements, and we all want that firm and youthful skin, but sometimes it seems like no matter what we do, we can't achieve that perfect look. And when it comes to listening to those celebrities out there who don't admit what they've done, they often tout what? Diet, exercise, olive oil, and most recently, horseback riding. Well, that's a bunch of horse, but fortunately, there are some supplements out there that can indeed help us achieve our goal of tighter, brighter skin with glow. And my fourth supplement today, I bet many of you are taking it topically, but not orally. I'm going to take you through exactly how you can get the recommended amount of that one. My number one is collagen. Now, collagen is a protein. It's naturally found in our bodies, but our collagen production, it decreases with age, and collagen supplements can help improve skin elasticity and reduce wrinkles. And we now have studies, objective studies with camera and 3D imaging that show these results.
So the test product, the collagen, significantly improved skin hydration, elasticity, roughness, and density, and the differences were statistically significant, and they were substantially retained during follow-up, meaning they lasted.
Collagen supplements come in many forms, and so many people are confused. They come in pills, in powders, in liquids, and you can add collagen just to your smoothie or even make it at home as a broth. And I have videos I'll put in the more info section below so you can make your own collagen at home. But I prefer collagen powder. I think the powder works the best. You're looking for hydrolyzed collagen, which is little pieces of protein.
This is what you're looking for. Bovine, beef broth, chicken bone broth, eggshell membrane, and hydrolyzed fish collagen. You may as well get them all, and you can see why they can't be plant-based. Collagen by nature comes from animals.
You also want to look for collagen types 1, 2, 3, 5, and 10. Those are the whole collagen pieces. And for the vegans out there, unfortunately, there is no such thing as vegan collagen. By nature, it's derived from animals. My second supplement is vitamin C. Vitamin C is an antioxidant that can help reduce the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles. It also helps to stimulate collagen production. Loss and lack of collagen and that machinery that I talked about is what leads to sag. When I say machinery, what I'm trying to tell you, both with collagen and hyaluronic acid, is our body produces it. It also chews it up. As we age, we produce less, we chew up more. So we have a relative deficiency.
Check out this study, decreased collagen production by chronologically aged skin. And keep in mind, people age much quicker now than they did years ago. But check it out, reduced synthesis of collagen types 1 and 3 is characteristic of chronologically aged skin. The present report provides evidence of both cellular and fibroblast aging and defective mechanical stimulation in the aged tissue contributed to reduced collagen synthesis. The reduction in collagen synthesis due to fibroblasts, so fibroblasts produce collagen, was demonstrated by lower in vitro, so this was an in test tube study, in production of, this is important because this is what we're trying to build, type 1 procollagen by dermal fibroblasts. So we're looking for 1 and 3 in general. And keep in mind, you age quicker, not by chronological only, but by your diet, by your exercise, by your aging rate, by autophagy.
So vitamin C can help this along, of course, with the collagen powder that I mentioned. But not many people know that humans, along with other primates and guinea pigs, are unable to produce vitamin C in their bodies. We can't make it. It's due to a genetic mutation that occurs millions of years ago that disabled that gene responsible for producing the enzyme. Are you ready? L-glucolactone oxidase. And that's required for the synthesis of vitamin C. As a result, we must obtain it from our diet or supplementation. You can take vitamin C supplements or you can take vitamin C rich foods. Some people don't like those. That's the problem. What are they? Things like oranges, kiwis and strawberries. And now those things have gotten actually expensive. Of course, topically is supreme. Many of you I know are using a vitamin C topically and you apply it therefore directly to the skin so you get the best absorption. And as an aside, yes, you may use it in the morning. I don't know why I get asked that all the time. People somehow were told you shouldn't use it in the morning, but when you use it topically, yes, apply it in the morning because as the day goes, you're getting UV damage and sun damage, and vitamin C that you put on neutralizes that. Very important. If I'm out going in the water, going windsurfing, kite surfing, I always put my vitamin C on the morning before my sunscreen. So what's the recommended daily intake of vitamin C for adults? Between 75 and 90 milligrams per day. But some studies suggest a higher dose, and you know some of the longevity gurus take very high doses of vitamin C. But there are studies that showing a little bit more than our daily intake, 4 to 5 times, might in fact be beneficial, particularly for skin. For example, a study published in the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition that found that consuming 500 milligrams of vitamin C per day for 4 weeks, just 4 weeks, led to significant improvements in skin elasticity. For reference, think about a medium-sized orange that contains 70 milligrams of vitamin C. So you need several oranges in the run of a day to get to that 500 milligram level. In my plasma restore vitamin, I put 180 milligrams in there. Of course, there's other things. It's a glow type of vitamin. So I also put vitamin A, E. Never forget zinc. It's necessary for collagen production. I also put a blend of natural fruit antioxidants in there. My topical vitamin C serum, it's 15%, and there's 3 different types of vitamin C. A lot of people wonder what percentage of topical you should place. Think about anything above 10% if it's a great product, meaning fairly fresh, and if it has bioavailability. From a clinical point of view, it is important to note that the efficacy, so the effectiveness of vitamin C serum is proportional to the concentration, but only up to 20%. The half-life in the skin after achieving maximal concentration is 4 days, and you should use it in the AM, and if you want the PM, that's fine too. So some esterified forms of vitamin C, they just don't absorb well. I include 3 different types just to make sure we're covered with different forms. Remember, some forms might oxidize more quickly. Now, my third supplement is omega-3 fatty acids.
Did you know that before fish oil was used as a supplement, it was used to lubricate clocks and watches, and it was revered because it prevented oxidation and kept everything running smoothly.
These are essential fatty acids and they're important for healthy skin, and particularly I included it here because they add so much glow to people's skin. They help to reduce inflammation, which of course leads to aging of the skin, poor texture and poor tone. Omega-3 supplements can be found in fish oil capsules. Probably most of you take fish oil. There's a better one I'll tell you about in a minute. But you can also use omega-3 rich foods, salmon, flaxseed, chia seeds. Now I want to know in the comments below how many of you take those, because when I ask my patients, a lot of them don't like fish. They don't like the fish breath, the smell when they cook it in their home. They don't eat chia seeds or flax seeds. What do I like? Krill oil. It's a better choice for omega-3 fatty acids for a few reasons. Number one, more bioavailability, which means more omega-3s in krill versus fish oil. Also, they're in the phospholipid form, and that's closer to the structure of the fats in our cell membranes, making it easier for our bodies to absorb and use and incorporate into the skin. Second, with krill oil, the antioxidant contains astaxanthin, the most powerful, or thought to be by many, the most powerful antioxidant on earth, along with maybe resveratrol would be right up there, but it helps protect the omega-3s from oxidation and degradation. That means it's less likely to go rancid, they're much smaller tablets, they're much more stable, and you don't get often that fishy, burpy breath that some people get with fish oils. It's also much more sustainable, comes from cold water in the Antarctic. My fourth one and my final one, but in no particular order, is vitamin A. Now this might be new to some of you, and here's a cool fact, It's not new in the sense that it's part of a group of compounds that includes retinol, retinal, and retinoic acid. Now, you know those because I have retinols in my skincare line. Also, many of you are on a retinol or hopefully preferably retinaldehyde, but you can also take it orally, and that's important as well. Vitamin A is essential for the health of our skin, not just our eyes, but also our skin. And taking it orally or by mouth can provide a range of benefits. It promotes cell growth, regeneration, enhancing collagen production, and reducing fine lines, wrinkles, improving acne, and supporting hydration. Things that support hydration make people look younger. Another one in that class would be hyaluronic acid. For acne sufferers, vitamin A is, of course, a common ingredient. That's how retinol or retinoic acid in particular was invented. It was used initially for acne and then found to be anti-aging. So taking it orally has many beneficial effects for people who are prone to acne because it can help regulate the production of sebum, and that's the oily substance that leads to clogged pores and breakouts. So what's the dose? In my plasma restore vitamin, I do include it. I use 500 micrograms. In the United States, the recommended daily allowance for vitamin A ranges from 300 micrograms for infants, usually, to all the way up to 900 micrograms for adults. Adult men in particular. Adult women, recommended daily dose or RDA is 700 micrograms per day. It's worth noting here that it's a fat soluble vitamin, and that means it can accumulate in the body over time. So consuming high doses could be toxic, and you don't want to necessarily do that. What are some signs? Nausea, dizziness, even liver damage. So don't overdo it with oral vitamin A. There's no need. The doses I talked about are great and enough for collagen production, elastin, and support of the skin. So collagen, vitamin C, omega-3 fatty acids, and vitamin A, they all help with skin support, elastin, glow, and structure. Add those supplements to your diet. I want to know below, what's your favorite form of using it? Stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.